How you recover when good apps go bad. Yep, I'm taking my own advice. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you're watching this out on YouTube, be sure and hit like towards the end of the video if you determine that this is something that was interesting and helpful to you. That kind of stuff helps me, of course, but it also helps other people at YouTube find the things that they're looking for when they're searching. Over time, we all get comfortable with the software we use on a regular basis. It's just natural. You know how it works. You're comfortable with the interface. It has the features you want. They work the way you expect them to work. And then something changes. Then you've got a problem. That problem is something needs to change as well. Either you need to change to accommodate whatever the change in the application was, or you need to change applications. Unfortunately, simply complaining about it usually doesn't help. It's uncommon for the complaints we express about certain features and changes to actually have a dramatic impact. And even when they do, as we'll see here in a moment, even when they do, it's usually a case where the change that results in response to our complaints doesn't happen fast enough. We still have to at least cope with whatever it is we're dealing with when we have that unexpected change. Now, I say that I had to take my own advice because you know what? This happened to me. And I want to run through my example specifically because it's a very good example of taking my own advice and dealing with a change that, to be honest, I couldn't live with. I've been an Evernote user. I continue to be an Evernote user. I'm not abandoning Evernote over this particular problem. I've used it for many years to track notes and documents and much, much more. In recent years, I've been using it to track my time. I use it to track my to-do list. There's an article, How to Build a Productive System with Evernote to Get Things Done, that outlines basically what I'm doing. It's a combination of notebooks and tags that allow you to organize and update and schedule and filter the various to-do lists that we all have. And Lord knows I have a long one. There's so many things. So I've been doing that, like I said, for a couple of years. And it's been working really, really well for me. I've been very pleased with it until about 2 months ago. 2 months ago, I finally took the plunge and updated to the most recent version of Evernote. I had been running the old one because I knew that they were making some major changes to the program, and I wanted to delay having to deal with that for as long as possible. The time had come to update, and I did. And yes, there's lots of changes. Most of them didn't affect me. It's prettier. It's certainly more consistent across all the platforms, which I believe is one of the reasons they made the changes that they did. Supposedly, it is also a better architecture on the back end that allows them to deal with change and future feature enhancements a little bit more effectively and a little bit more stably. But there's a design decision they made that impacted me in a way that I suspect they didn't anticipate. One of the ways that my to-do system worked is I used tags a lot. And say one of those tags would say, this is something that has to be done today. In order to say that I was done with that particular item, I'd simply remove the tag. And the list of things that I had to do today would shrink by one. The change that Evernote made, as I understand it, and in fact that they admitted and discussed, is that the search that happens, the filtering based on tag that used to happen in the application on the PC, was now happening on the Evernote servers. What that meant, of course, is that the application was communicating with the server saying, do this search, and then getting the results back from the server. I can envision a few reasons that makes a certain amount of sense, but the upshot was that if the server took too long, it looked like the search didn't happen. And in fact, the search was taking minutes and sometimes hours. The ramification on me was that I would make a change to my to-do list and the change would not take effect. The search for all of the items that were tagged to be done today would include all sorts of items that I'd already done, where I just removed the tags. Or if I'd added something, if I added a new task to be done today, it wouldn't show up on the list. That was not something I could live with. Now, as I said, I confirmed with Evernote that this was in fact a problem. They were public about it in the forum, and I wasn't the only person experiencing this specific problem. And in fact, they've promised an update that will address this somehow. They haven't indicated how, but I trust them that they will do something that will make the feature work again. In the meantime, I'm stuck. I can't use Evernote as I had been for the last 2 years to manage my to-do list. So I started looking for alternatives. That's taking my own advice. It's one of those things where I commonly tell people that, you know what, if you can't tolerate a particular change that happens to an operating system, an application, a device, or whatever, what's in your control is your ability to use something else. What's in your control is your ability to, as I sometimes put it, vote with your feet. My feet took me to a different application. I did a fair amount of research and I ended up switching to an application called Todoist. Todoist is dedicated to managing to-do lists. It was convenient in the past for me to be able to have all of my information in one place in Evernote. Moving the to-do list specifically out of Evernote and into an application that is designed specifically for that has proven to be actually a much better solution. It works and it works well. I'm happy with it. I've since moved everything that is to-do related into Todoist and I've been using it successfully for several weeks now. I still use Evernote. Evernote is still my repository for random notes, article ideas, document archives, any number of different random things that Evernote is actually really, really good at still. On the way, I did investigate using other note-taking apps. I did investigate actually switching away from Evernote completely. Unfortunately, all of the alternatives that I ran into had issues. They had limitations. They were all good programs. Don't get me wrong. The ones I investigated were all reasonable and popular note-taking applications, but they all had some kind of limitation that impacted the way I use the software. Naturally, I'd become so used to Evernote. Yeah, I was kind of relying on its feature set. So being able to take this one chunk of feature out of Evernote and into an application that was specifically designed to do exactly what I'm trying to do, lets me do that more effectively and lets me continue to use Evernote in the way that I'm used to using Evernote. So, what does this mean for you? Why am I telling you about my troubles with Evernote and my move to Todoist? This is not an uncommon scenario. Like I said, software changes. It just does over time. That's one of the things that I think we can assume about just about anything we use, be it the operating system, be it our favorite applications, be it our not so favorite applications. Something's going to change at some point. At some point, you may find that that change is too much for you. Here's what I suggest you do. One, identify the problem. Be specific about the problem. It was very easy for me to spend a lot of time looking at general purpose note-taking applications, but the answers became clearer when I really tried to identify the problem I was trying to solve, managing my to-do list. Look for existing alternatives. In other words, look for what you already have, be it other applications already installed on your machine, other applications that you're already familiar with, maybe other applications that you're already paying for. In my case, for example, one of the items that I investigated was OneNote. OneNote is part of Microsoft Office and I have it. As I said, there were some limitations that didn't work for me. It may be a scenario where something you already have, something you already have access to, is a viable alternative for whatever it is you're trying to do. Third, give them a chance. Definitely reach out to the support forums, the support mechanisms that are available for whatever the program is. In many cases, you may get no satisfaction. That is just the reality of life these days. In many cases, you'll also get confirmation. Confirmation is wonderful because it says, yeah, it's not just me. This is an actual problem with the application. That can actually remove a fair amount of frustration. Sometimes you'll get workarounds, maybe from the company or maybe from some of the other users who are experiencing the same problem. In the discussion for this specific problem, there actually were no real workarounds. Everybody was in the same situation I was. The feature didn't work. Some of them went off and used other techniques. Some of them went off and used other programs. Some of them are just being patient and letting Evernote acknowledge that there is a problem and that they do intend to fix it soon. But there's no deadline, of course. And finally, the fourth one is the approach that I ended up taking. Investigate new alternatives. There is so much out there these days, so many solutions to so many problems, that it is very possible you may find something that serves you better. As I said, while I've been using Evernote happily for the past couple of years, this kind of forced me to look for an alternative to solve that specific time management problem, and the result is I have a better solution. I have a more effective time management system. Depending on what it is you're facing when you're running into trouble with the software you use, you might be pleasantly surprised over something that you stumbled into when you're trying to deal with somebody else's change. I hope this was helpful. I hope this gives you some food for thought when you're dealing with the inevitable change on your PC, on its software. For related links, including links to Evernote, and Todoist, to the discussion forum, the time management system I happen to use, that's all in the original article on which this video is based. That's out at askleo.com/129145. As always, I'm Leo Notenboom. Thanks for watching.